Let's solve together our first related rates problem. The radius of a particular circle increases at 1 millimeter each second. As a result, its area changes. How fast is its area changing when its radius is 20 millimeters? We'll use our four-step problem-solving strategy for related rates problems to tackle this, since it works every time. We first draw a picture of the physical situation, which is a circle, with a radius that we'll label r. The problem gives us the rate at which the radius increases. That rate is dr dt, the rate at which the radius r changes with respect to time t. And that equals 1 millimeter per second. The problem asks us something about the circle's area that we'll label A. The problem wants us to find how fast that area is changing, which means we need to find the rate dA dt, the rate at which the area A changes with respect to time t. We want that rate at a particular instant when r equals 20 millimeters. So we're given the value of dr dt, and we're asked something about dA dt. We thus need to find the relation between those two quantities. Now clearly, as the circle's radius increases, its area increases as well. Furthermore, if the radius increases more quickly, then the circle's area also increases more quickly. The rate at which the area A changes, dA dt, is thus somehow related to the rate at which the radius r changes, dr dt. Our job is to find the exact relationship between those two quantities. In order to find that relation, we first back up a step and need to find a relation between A and r. That takes us to the second step of our problem-solving strategy, to write an equation that relates the quantity of interest, in this case between A and R. In any related rates problem that you solve, you'll use one of four approaches that you need to know to complete this step. We cover each of them in our free materials on our website. This problem uses the easiest of those four approaches, a geometric fact that you either know or can look up. Here, we just need the formula for the area of a circle in terms of its radius, a equals pi r squared. Now, a common mistake at this point is to substitute 20 millimeters for r, but you can't proceed correctly if you do that. Instead, because the value of the radius changes as the circle grows, we have to leave r as a variable for now. We'll substitute r equals 20 millimeters at the end of our solution. The equation a equals pi r squared actually completes the second step of our problem-solving strategy, since that's the relation between a and r that we need. So we can move to the third step and take the derivative with respect to time of both sides of our equation, remembering the chain rule when we do so. The derivative of the left-hand side of the equation gives us d dt of the circle's area a, and that equals the derivative of the right side of the equation, d dt of pi r squared. On the left-hand side, the derivative with respect to time t of the area A is the rate dA dt. On the right-hand side of the equation, we can pull pi out, since that's a constant, and we're left with the derivative d dt of r squared, and that derivative is 2r times dr dt. The 2r part is probably clear to you, since we started with r squared. If the dr dt part is also clear to you, you can use the link you should now see to skip over the next part of our discussion, which is a detour for a bit to discuss why that dr dt term is there. The key thing to realize is that we're taking the derivative here with respect to time t. And specifically, while the derivative with respect to r of r squared is 2r, the derivative with respect to time t of r squared is 2r times dr dt. Why is that dr dt term there? To answer that question, let's go back to our expression for the circle's area, a equals pi r squared, but now let's explicitly show the time dependence of both a and r, which are both functions of time t, so we'll show them as such just to emphasize that point. Let's again take the derivative with respect to time of both sides of the equation, so we have d dt of area as a function of time t equals d dt of pi times the radius as a function of time t squared. Now the left-hand side, again, is the rate dA of t dt. On the right-hand side of the equation, we can again pull the pi out since that's a constant, and we're left with the derivative d dt of something in brackets that's squared. As usual, when we take the derivative, the 2 comes down in front, and we have pi times 2 times that thing in brackets, which is r of t. But we also have to remember the chain rule and apply d dt to what's inside the brackets, which gives us the chain rule term d dt of r of t. Let's be clear, r is a function of time t, even though we don't know exactly what that function is. It doesn't matter. Whatever the function is, it has a derivative with respect to time t, and that is this term d dt of r of t. And this last term, due to the chain rule, is very important when you're solving related rates problems, and it's easy to forget. Though if you do forget it, you'll probably quickly realize your omission when you notice that you don't have a dr dt term anywhere. That's a reminder to go back and put this chain rule term in. Now this last term, d dt of r of t, is the rate d r of t dt. And so we now see again how the rates dA dt and dr dt are related. Remember that we explicitly wrote the area A and radius R here as functions of time t in order to emphasize why the chain rule term dr dt is there. Typically, you would never write all that out, instead just writing A equals pi r squared, as we did earlier, and then take the derivative and work your way to the result, pi times 2r times dr dt, of course remembering the chain rule term there. The math is all the same in the right and left columns. We're now just not writing out all of the explicit time dependencies. So with that, let's return to where we were in our solution. Continuing on here, we can rearrange the terms on the right-hand side of the equation, so we have dA dt equals 2 pi r times dr dt. And that completes the third step of our problem-solving strategy, since we now have the relation between dA dt and dr dt that we need. The fourth and final step of our strategy is then simply to solve for the quantity we're after. Remember that we want the value of dA dt, which we just found equals 2 pi r times dr dt. So we have dA dt equals 2 pi times r, and we're interested in the moment when r equals 20 millimeters, so we can make that substitution, and then times dr dt, which equals 1 millimeter per second. And now just a little math, 2 pi times 20 times 1 is 40 pi, and the units are millimeters squared per second, which are just the units we expect for the rate of change of an area, which should be millimeters squared, with respect to time, which is measured in seconds. And that's it. Our final answer is 40 pi millimeters squared per second. Here's a summary screen of the four steps that we used to solve this problem, so you can screen grab it if you'd like. Remember that we use these same four steps to solve every related rates problem that we encounter, and you can too. You can download the problem-solving strategy for yourself and see a lot more calculus problems, each with a completely worked-out solution, at our website, mathano.com. Please also subscribe to our YouTube channel, and you can immediately go to a video solution of another related rates problem that illustrates a different approach that you need to know in step two. For now, please let us know the questions you have or any suggestions. We'll do our best to help.